Hi, I'm Eric Lanask here at IT Expo in Miami, Florida, and I'm talking with Cloud Passage's Chris Brenton. Chris, thanks for joining me.
Nice to meet you, Eric.
So tell me a little bit about who Cloud Passage is and what do you do?
Cloud Passage is a infrastructure as a service security company. We tend to focus on infrastructure as a service, although quite honestly the product will run on standalone servers. I actually run it on a few of my desktop systems to secure that. Where it's different from most of the security products that are out in the market today is that it's fully portable. With the introduction of cloud, especially hybrid, especially with mobile coming in now, we're seeing more instances of where folks may have a server, let's say, on their internal private network, and on occasion they need to burst that out to one or more providers. One of the things that can kind of inhibit that is the fact that if I take a server that's internal and it's sitting behind a firewall, move it out to a public infrastructure, obviously I've lost that perimeter security. What we do is we actually secure the virtual machine itself. So as it moves over to Rackspace, Amazon, Teledyne, whatever the case may be, whatever security policy has been put in place actually moves around with the virtual machine itself.
So there's no question that security is necessary when you're talking about the cloud. There's also no question that's always been a big question mark in terms of businesses being afraid or being skeptical about the cloud. Is that changing?
Absolutely. Still today, when you look at the studies, that's usually number one or number two, security being the inhibitor. Mm-hmm. And I think what it is it's a different mindset. I mean, cloud is more disruptive to our infrastructure than literally since we moved from mainframes to PCs. So it requires a complete rethink of how to do things. And, you know, how do I manage security on a server-by-server basis, and then you need to deal with what's this bursting thing, that tends to kind of throw a lot of people off. Personally, I don't think implementing security in the cloud is any harder or easier than what we've done legacy-wise. It's just it's different. For example, I might have tools that would allow me to go through and methodically check who logs into what servers and when. Once you get into cloud, if they're public-facing systems, typically nobody logs in. So security becomes a little easier because now I can say, okay, yeah, someone logged in, they got the password right on the first try, but nobody's supposed to be logging into that box. That's something I need to worry about. Whereas in the past, that wouldn't be enough evidence for me to know, yeah, okay, there's something I got to investigate.
So is it fair to say that then the perception of security in the cloud are not necessarily accurate on the business side?
It's all a matter of expertise. And anytime you have change is hard. We all know that. So I think that's a lot of what actually drives that perception. I think as folks start dabbling in it, as they start seeing, you know, yeah, there are tools on the market today that I can use to leverage, and, you know, yeah, all right, I just got to look at this a little different than I'm used to, they all of a sudden start realizing it's actually not so bad.
Who has to buy into it on the enterprise side? Is it the C-level suite, or is it the actual IT guys doing the work?
The C-levels, the DevOps, they're all gung-ho. The tough ones are the security folks, you know, the CISOs, especially if they've, you know, come up through the 90s and the 2000s where this is how you do security, and now all of a sudden it's different and they're trying to figure out how to adapt. That seems, you know, anytime we've gone into an organization, like I said, DevOps, they're all for it. Even the C-levels, when they start looking at the dollar signs they can save, they're all for it. It's the security folks that get freaked out and say, oh, my God, what are you trying to get me to do?
So what are you at Cloud Passage doing to help change that that viewpoint?
Well, a couple of things. One is obviously the product. The other is education. We run a community site that, you know, is somewhat product-focused, but it's actually more focused on security in general within the cloud. And really, for us, it's been kind of an education effort. You know, okay, so you're used to doing it this way. This is how you need to look at it now. You know, that type of thing. Try to get enough positive information out there that folks can turn to. We're also big supporters of the Cloud Security Alliance that's doing the same type of thing. Get enough positive information that folks can go out there and say, okay, yeah, right, I can perform steps A, B, and C, and that'll get me the same level of risk mitigation I'm used to. Yeah, okay, maybe this isn't so bad after all.
When it comes to securing the cloud, is it the enterprise that's responsible? Is the cloud provider that's responsible?
Oh,
is it both?
Question. It's actually both, and it is kind of frightening to me how often folks don't realize that. I've talked to literally multiple CISOs that have said, I don't have to worry about security, my provider takes care of that. And when you look at something like infrastructure as a service, the provider's taking care of some of the security. You know, they're making sure the doors are locked, they're making sure people can't physically steal the server. But when you look at who's responsible for making sure that the software is patched and up to date, that nobody breaks into the box, that a forensic analysis gets performed, intrusion detection's getting performed, that all falls back on the tenant. That all falls back on the person who's, you know, purchasing the service from the provider. And, you know, again, I think we're in kind of the early stages still, and most people kind of have, yeah, no, I don't want to hear that. I outsourced it. It shouldn't be my problem anymore.
I understand. Well, I certainly wish you well in trying to get that message across.
Thank you, Eric. Appreciate it.
Chris, thank you so much for joining me.
Thanks.